Fuck. All right, I'll be back. I gotta hold on.
Oh, all right.
Episodes in, we broke tradition.
We did. I know.
For the sake of the intro, though.
For the sake of the fucking, the goods.
Hope you guys enjoyed that.
Well, here we are, once again, After Death Podcast. Wait, no, we don't. Okay, hold on.
Keep going.
I'm doing it. I'm doing the head. I'm doing the full head.
You want to admit that I was right?
No. I don't, but...
Fucking gaslighter. You hear that? Someone left the gas on.
Shut the fuck up! I was like, wait, what? Fucker. God damn it. Well, welcome back, guys, to the After Death Podcast, episode 14. Holy shit. I say it's been a mission to get here every time, but it really is. I feel like that's... I'm crying wolf every time.
Yeah, no one believes you anymore.
No one believes me, but with this time, it really was a mission. But before we get into all that and everything that we're going to talk about, this episode is sponsored by Beer Fridge. More about that later in the episode. Thank you guys for sticking with us all the way through to episode 14.
Yep.
You know what, to be honest, I don't even know if it's... Has it been 6 months, 7 months? 8 foot punch! That we've been doing it already?
The podcast? No, I think we started in January.
January? So about 3 years. So thanks, guys, for sticking up.
What time is it? 3 years.
I'm just old with a beard now?
Yeah.
Oh, no, we're not going to do that. So it'd take too long. Yeah. But yeah, no.
It's been a lot of fun. Thank you for everyone giving us our views. We got up to... 2200 views, right?
2200 views on Joe's episode. Yeah. For you, those of you who haven't seen it, Joe is a fucking incredible...
Oh, yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, he's very smart. Yeah. Anybody who is... If you're watching now, the After Death Podcast, download Obaki. Obaki. Joe just got back from New York. He's going back to Thailand. But he was it. What do they call it? NASDAQ?
He did interviews. His company made it to NASDAQ, so he's on the public trading market, whatever that means. I mean,
buy your stocks.
It's some shit that's beyond me, to be honest. Yeah. But I mean, you see him at all these like fancy ass fucking parties, eating like giant fucking plates with like a little tiny pink inside. So like it's $300 for.
Cheers. Ooh. Download Obaki, check out that episode, learn more about that app, and support our friend.
Yes.
Fuck yeah, to you, Joe. Congrats. He actually got two of his companies on NASDAQ.
Oh, yeah, it's Obaki and M-Star, right?
M-Star, yeah.
Yeah. Dude, that's is that the only CEO that we know?
We know a GM.
We know a GM, yes, we do.
Aside from people from work, but...
Yeah, but I think that is the first
Oh yeah, I mean he got his 2,200 views. Yeah, he's got way more followers on Instagram and stuff. But
yeah,
hell yeah,
we appreciate it more than Turtle. Fuck you, Turtle.
So we actually lost an episode. So after Joe, we recorded Cameron's episode. Our friend Cameron Zavala on Instagram, Cameron _ Zavala, C A V A L A, and it was such a good episode, but.
Dude,
somebody, not saying who.
Yes, okay.
Somebody starts with a T. Sabotaged our episode again.
God fucking damn that T bastard.
Yeah, we got sabotaged. We recorded a 3-hour episode with no audio.
You'd think those kind of animals are the slowest and the most, dumbest animals.
Misogynistic.
Most misogynistic, you know, turtles actually hit their turtle counterparts.
Yeah, we're not gonna name any names, but
I just talked about animals.
Look, I'm not against hitting women, okay?
But I mean,
wait,
the proof is in the pudding,
mm-hmm.
And the proof is in the podcast, and I think the proof is really in the podcast. When it comes to production value, I'm just saying. I want to let that sit in for a little while. You know who I'm talking to. Okay.
Fuck, my other one didn't work.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of which, Ernie got a new little toy.
Yes, I did. Let's play some. Let's show you what I got.
I fuck your wife, Custer.
That's what he's got.
I know someone that will like this one.
I like that.
It's like so low too.
What's up there, Chomo? Fucking asshole.
Speaking of, no, just kidding.
Oh shit.
But yeah, we recorded a whole fucking episode with no audio, but it's shot so well.
Yeah. We'll play some, or actually we do it. Okay, so
let's show you guys.
So the reason why it was shot so beautifully is we just got a new light. As always, we're always upgrading this shit. We're getting getting more stripper poles. We're getting more clamps. You know what? To be honest, it kind of said we got clamps, poles, rods.
Yeah.
It sounds like a fucking sex dungeon in here.
Yeah.
And we got lights and umbrellas and shit. But no, we got a new light, and the production value went up even more. And then with that episode, it looked fucking beautiful.
Yeah.
And we had like more creative control over the way things looked, and unfortunately we couldn't do the whole episode, which was like, I think it was 3 hours, and it was like packed full of like artistic content, dude.
Like just talking about all the art that he does, because he's a painter. And what was the, he said he does not illustration, but
zines.
Yeah, he does zines,
magazines,
like it's like comic books. He makes his own comic books, sells them for super cheap, and makes them himself. Mm-hmm. So it's fucking awesome. And it takes a lot of time. And we saw his storyboard writing process. And
dude, because I always think to myself, like I said it in the episode, which is fucking lost to the fucking ether.
Yeah.
But I said it before. Just like the process, dude, like how he comes up with it. Which, and it's totally different from you, totally different from me, because we're all artistic and we all create things, but it's all every
in different
artist
ways, yeah.
So amazing.
Yeah,
I fucking love it.
And then he just got back from a zine festival.
Mm-hmm.
So he was, you know, showcasing his art. He had a lot of comic books. I thought he did maybe 4 comic books. He did like 10, and he's working on like a 300 page or 600 page
like fucking epic.
Yeah.
What do they call it in
graphic novel?
Graphic novel, yeah.
Yeah. Well, he called it a zine, but I'm like, dude, I think that's a graphic novel.
Yeah. Once the page count goes over like 12.
It'd be cool if we can get him in a Uptown Whittier comic book shop.
Yes. If only we knew somebody.
Nerds. Yeah. But too bad they're
fucking asshole.
I love that soundbite.
The laugh really sells it. It really brings it home.
Yeah. But, well, who knows? You know, you definitely can't showcase that art. Like, you got to keep it behind the desk.
Well, I mean, I think you can, right?
No.
I mean, the Deadpool kills everyone.
Yeah, but there's no, like, prolapsed anus.
There could be.
Comic book drawings in that.
I'm pretty
sure. It's bloody, but yeah. Cameron's on some
crazy. If anything, that's Turtle's favorite, and he probably has a whole collection of it.
Mm.
So let us know in the comments, Turtle, about your weird prolapse comic book
collection. Yeah, he might buy the whole collection.
Yeah.
But here's some test footage from that episode. I'll show you guys.
Yeah, so like as with this podcast, you know, we're always changing lighting and shit. Oh yeah, we put some music and shit behind
it. Put some lo-fi music.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, there's Cameron talking about just all the different things. Like, we grew up together in high school. Really good friend. But yeah, we were just messing around with the color grading in this episode, and it came out really good, if I don't say so myself.
And he did. And I say so myself.
Chris did a great job.
I just realized this sounds like low-key porn music.
But yeah, check out Cameron's art. Cameron_Zavala.
Yeah.
On Instagram.
And we'll put his links down. We're going to do it
in this description.
Yeah.
I wish we got to... Maybe we can air the whole episode with no audio and see if people like that. Just skim through it. Look through through the art.
Yeah. No, we really should.
If anybody can read lips, we would love to pay you to... translate everything.
And we'll call it the After Death Podcast.
After Death Podcast, yeah.
So, but yeah, that was fucking beautiful, and, you know, it was a loss. I took it kind of hard. I went on a drinking binge for 2 weeks. I'm back, but I feel great.
Yeah.
So the things we try to do in the meantime to make up for that podcast was, what do we do?
Well, we needed content to air, mm-hmm. which is why we're here today. This episode airs tomorrow.
Yeah.
As you heard in the intro, it will be late. We need to edit and, clean it up, color correct, all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But we're
getting it in, and it's better to come late than not at all.
Yeah. Let's see. So we did get content for... we lost that episode, but we went to a backyard show that, we were invited to.
And to be honest, that was we almost didn't go to that.
Yeah, we almost didn't go, but it's such a good band. Mm-hmm. The band is Wilder, with the period at the end. Mm-hmm. And they, I was just talking to them in the DMs, and I was asking them if they need a photographer, videographer for the backyard show that they're having. And they were just like, yeah, dude, come through. So I was like, Chris, I'm super tired. I don't know if we should go. But he's like, no, let's go. I'm packing up already.
And we had work early in the morning.
Yeah, we had work early in the morning. We went a little late, but because we were working a football game.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I was glad we went because it was a lot of fun. As soon as we walked in, immediately got recognized by the bandmates.
And I got to say... You're fucking luck with this shit, bro. I don't understand. Like, I mean, like, yeah, you DM'd him, right?
Yeah.
But then he was like...
Yeah, he's like, what's up, dude?
You're the guy!
Yeah, as soon as I walked into the backyard, and it was Steven who was like... He's like, hey, Ernie, right? And I was like, oh, shit, what's up, dude? Like, I was kind of, like, gonna let them walk around and...
Yeah.
Do their thing. I didn't want to bother them because I'm sure people go up to them.
Yeah,
but he came up to me and he started talking, and we come to find out he's the GM of Three Weavers. So hopefully another sponsor. That'd be cool.
Shit.
That'd be cool if we had Three Weavers sponsors on here.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we just started talking about music, and hey, we're gonna record here, and we're just it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be loose.
Mm-hmm.
Just a quick video, so we'll get that going.
Yeah.
And then after we finished talking with Steven, Nick was like, is that Ernie? Literally just like that. And I was like, what's up, dude? And so we started talking about music and how and their old band, which was
Hearts Like Lions.
And that was such a good band. I listen to them in my car now.
Yeah.
But I play Wilder at least 3 times a day.
Yeah. Dude,
I can't stop. Like, they're stuck in my head. It's so good.
Yeah.
That's like fun party music.
Yep.
So check out Wilder. Wilder's a good ass band.
When you want to get wilder.
And we are working on that footage, right?
Yep, we're working on it.
It's a little tough.
If we have it, yeah. There it is.
If not, you'll see the error message.
Yeah.
It's still there.
It's still there.
Okay, it's gone.
No.
Now it's gone.
Why do you always take it away?
But, yeah, we had lots of fun. It was a great show. Mm-hmm. Very intimate. And your first backyard show? Have you got any others? Did you go to Hobbies?
I didn't go to Hobbies.
Yeah.
That's what I thought it was going to be like. But it wasn't. Yeah. No. So, yeah, that's my first backyard show. And what a backyard show it was. It was fucking chill as fuck.
Yeah, it was chill. The swimming pool?
Ooh. Dude, yeah.
They had a swimming pool with beer. It was awesome. And we got to try, because he's the GM of Three Weavers, we got to try some beers that's not released yet. And it was... Yeah. By far the best beer I've ever fucking had.
Yeah.
Hands down.
No, honestly.
That flavor was insane.
I had like 4 of them that night.
Yeah, it was so good.
Yeah. So, Three Weavers. Whenever that shit comes out, I forgot the name of it already. I want to say it's called like Cider Puss, but I know it's not.
No. No. I forgot. It's actually at the bottom of the can.
Oh, it is, huh?
Yeah. They printed it on the bottom.
If only we had those cans.
Maybe in a few we might.
Yeah, maybe.
Well, I'm almost done.
Fuck, hold on.
Well, that was a lot of fun with Wilder. And again, we're working on that video. But after that, we went to see Mark Norman, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we wanted to give you guys something. And
comedy.
That's exactly what we're trying to do.
Yeah. How was that show for you?
Oh my god, dude! For some reason, it was like one under fucking
Shane
Gillis, yeah.
Yeah,
I think it was a great show.
If you guys don't know Mark Norman, the comedian, holy crap, he's so funny. He reminded me 1000% of George Carlin. Just quick, like observational humor and like fucking twisted shit,
bro. He was quick as fuck.
Yeah.
Like, okay.
It, like, doesn't give you enough time to think, like, wait, no, but it's like, he's just like, boom, boom, boom. Like, literally just one after the other after the other. And he's going for, like, 20 minutes, and then he catches his breath.
Yeah.
And then he talks to the crowd, and then just keeps going and going and going.
Dude, and the most effective crowd work I've seen.
Oh, yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, he was like, just yell out something.
And New York guys are fucking pros at that.
Yeah.
They know how to do crowd work. And and that was another cool thing, and another reason why we went there is because he is from New York.
Mm-hmm.
And so those guys in that circle really don't come over here and play. Like Shane Gillis, Sam Morril, which was in Irvine, we couldn't get to him.
Yeah, he sold out too.
Yeah. Fuck, dude. These guys
sell out.
We're
lucky we got our tickets because we went with our friend Chris. Chris and Brian, shout out to you guys.
Shout out.
And they had to pay like over $100 for like $130 for each ticket. And I was like, geez, we only paid $30. And literally like I bought our tickets. And I was just like, none of them were sold out except one night. And it was like a Saturday. So I was like, oh, maybe he's not going to sell out.
Yeah.
So I was like, let me just buy them just in case. And then like I sent a link to Brian and Chris and they got their tickets, but they didn't say, but they paid over $100 for those tickets. And I was like, damn, I got them just in time.
Yeah.
And then I wanted to see Sam Morril tonight.
Yeah.
But it sold out too.
Sold out.
Yeah. Those New York comics are hilarious. Mm-hmm.
But one thing that I've been thinking, I'm like, damn, we do got to get some Bodega Cat.
Yeah.
They don't sell it in stores, but they do it online. So
yeah. Which is easier.
Yeah.
And we got to meet Mark Norman and his opener. His opener gave us some koozies.
Yeah.
Kids go to hell too, not just heaven. They go to hell.
And I'll be honest, I don't fucking remember his name. But he was funny as fuck.
Yeah, he was pretty funny. He looked like, I want to say he looked like Zach from Scrubs.
Zach Braff.
Zach Braff.
Yeah.
He looked just like Zach Braff.
I was going to say he looked like Sam Morril and Mark Norman had a baby.
He did. He did too, huh? Yeah, he did. But yeah, that was a lot of fun with Chris. Got to meet Mark Norman, the opener. We got the shirt and the what are these called? Koozies?
Cozy. No, they're called koozies.
Yeah. And then we got some B-roll from the show.
Yes.
If you guys want to see that, here you go. Here you go.
Let's go. That's it.
Yeah. How you turned that around pretty quick. That was last night.
Yeah, that was.
That was pretty impressive.
When the footage is good, it's easy to do.
Yeah.
But yeah, so let us know if you like shit like that.
We'll be posting more stuff like that on our OnlyFans and Patreon.
Speaking of OnlyFans. I know we did say it yesterday, fucking last podcast.
Yeah.
We said it last podcast, that there is an OnlyFans, and there is. And, for those of you who had found it, it's not set up yet.
Did people find it?
I don't know. Maybe, you know. But yeah, so there was a certain interesting thing, that happened with the OnlyFans. But before we do that,
let's open them. Wilder, if you're watching, we're sorry we did take some beers, but that's how fucking good it is. We had to steal a couple for the show.
This one's a squirter.
Yeah. Oh, that color.
Does
it's a hazy IPA called Puff Tuffs.
Oh. Damn, bro. Getting a little wet and wilder.
You're right.
Wait, I actually kind of want to know where the name Wilder came from.
Yeah, hopefully we can get him on the show.
Dude. That'd be fucking amazing.
Oh, so like they're so fucking chill. Like we were just talking to them and I had asked them like if they were okay with us using their music for our intro.
Mm-hmm.
And I talked to, I won't say which one, but he, I almost said it. And he was like, bro, just use it. I don't give a fuck. I was like, yes. He's like, for real? He goes, yeah, bro. So
we appreciate it.
We're going to have some, we got some options because all their music is so good, but
mm-hmm.
Let's show you a little taste.
Ooh. For those of you who know the lyrics, sing along.
Yeah. Oh, dude, this beer smells so good.
They have a fucking banger on this one, bro.
Yeah. Hands down. Check out Three Weavers, check out Wilder, and get wild.
Try to learn this fucking riff. I just don't know how to do it.
Really?
It sounds so easy, but I don't know how to do it.
Wait, was that a clean wipe? That was a clean wipe.
Clean wipe! Oh my
Same
god.
Same wavelength, bro.
I got wet.
I barely caught that right now. See, because, yeah, he's playing guitar right there. Oh, these are the fucking boys, dude. I love these guys.
It's just some good time boys. I don't wanna be your replacement. I don't wanna see your face in. So I scream it out loud. I'm getting out. I'm far away from this town. But I still feel out of place. And I kinda wanna see your face. Oh, and that fucking telly, bro. Such a fucking sick color.
Is he actually just playing with a snare?
No, those are okay. Tom's in the record.
That's just a show, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Look at the swimming pool. There's a swimming pool.
Oh, love these guys.
Bro, and they got the colors. They got the colors on point. Look at that shit. Dude, honestly, like, low budget, but fucking just...
Oh, another fucking thing. Another clean wipe.
Shit like this, dude, is so inspiring to me. Like, how low budget, but how fucking sick can you make it?
Right. Yeah.
Like that, bro. Oh.
Look at his spraying.
Yeah, that's so fucking good, bro.
Yeah.
That's Turtle trying to throw shade, but he can't.
I wonder if we recognize those guys from the show.
Oh, maybe.
Not that guy. That one might be...
I recognize those fingers.
That might be Nick's brother.
Oh.
Wait, did they record it? Oh, okay, never mind.
Oh, so fucking good.
Yeah.
It literally is ear. It's not even. I can't even say it's ear candy. It's ear cocaine, because it gets you fucking hyped and you just want more and more and more and more and more.
Yeah, I mean that. Just the way they shoot their music videos too is just like, it screams after death.
Yeah, no, and to be honest, dude, like, apart from podcasting and shit like this is like relatively easy. Like, you set up three cameras, boom,
right?
You're done. dude, this is like the shit that I've always wanted to do is.
Like, it's what you did for your dad's birthday video.
Yeah.
I mean,
I don't know.
It all looks like one take, you know? Mm-hmm.
I fucking love that, though.
Like multicam, but I'm sure this is all just one camera.
Mm-hmm. Dude, in this right here. Oh, where is it?
I'm coming for you. There's Nick. There's Steven. The boys. And what's funny, I told them too. I was like, what beer do you guys drink so we can, you know, bring some for everybody?
Yeah.
And I didn't know who I was talking to because I was just talking to the band Instagram.
Oh, yeah.
And they said Coors Light and Three Weavers. Yeah. And I was like, those are very different beers. I'm like, yeah. Very different beers.
Yeah.
And so when we saw them in person, they were like, he's like, I'm the Coors Light and he's the Three Weavers.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, I got that after he said he's the GM. Well, yeah. I that would be so sick if we can get them on the show.
Mm-hmm.
Just talk about their old band, talk about this band.
Mm-hmm.
They said they toured with a lot like Birds.
Yeah.
They toured
dude.
With, what was some of the other bands that they said?
Fuck, I can't remember.
Yeah, it was too much adrenaline. It was a lot of fun.
I was a couple beers in.
But a lot like Birds, that's a big band. Mm-hmm. Tillian. They probably toured with Dance Gavin Dance.
Yeah.
But they said that their inspiration...
Green Day and Rage Against the Machine.
Rage Against the Machine.
Which, wildly different from this kind of music.
Yeah.
And, which is funny, like, listening to their old band, Hearts Like Lions, I'm mm-hmm. like, dude, it sounds like Circus Survive.
Yeah. Does
so motherfuckers.
It's actually I'm wearing a Circus Survive beanie.
Oh, you are.
Yeah. And right here, album Circus Survive.
Damn, bro.
Yep,
got a match and shit. But motherfuckers, listen to this band, dude. I've listened to them since 2014 when they're Hearts Like Lions.
Yeah, on Bandcamp.
On fucking Bandcamp, bro. Dude, that was where the shit was. That's where the good shit was, because those were the guys who didn't have enough money to make it to like a fucking
right.
Publishing label or whatever.
Just love for the game.
Love for the game, dude. And it was pay what you want, you know.
Right.
I took a lot of it for free.
Don't say that.
Well, because I was broke, motherfucker.
Yeah.
But it was pay what you want. I was broke, and so I fucking just, you know, downloaded that shit. But now
we're buying Three Weavers beers. We're yes. paying back. We're
paying it back.
Paying it forward.
We're paying it forward. We're paying it back. We're paying it sideways.
Yeah.
We're flipping it around and we're paying it from behind.
Yep. But yeah, fucking awesome show. Great time.
Mm-hmm.
What else did we do?
All right, guys. So
working on it.
We are working on After Death. Everything for
stickers,
you guys.
Stickers, shirts.
Sticker shirts. For the OGs that were around during After Death. In what, 2013?
Or 20? Yeah, probably, yeah.
It's on the...
like 14.
It's on the fucking... the intro.
Yeah.
It's on the intro. But for those of you who were around back then, we actually started off as a clothing brand. Mm-hmm. And we made one shirt. And we had a second in prototype. There were some discrepancies on whether or not we should use a logo like this. And I really like it. I really fucking love this logo. So I think we're going to use it on the next shirt or something like that.
Maybe. We'll get in trouble.
Pending, patent pending. Well, I don't think that company's alive anymore.
Yeah.
So we'll see. Yeah.
So I was thinking, I was talking to Reyna. Shout out Reyna.
Reyna.
What'd you say? And Chase and Eddie. Yeah. And she,
you know, I'm Chase and Eddie.
We were talking, so she was talking about the podcast, right? Mm-hmm. And I kind of just like on a limb thought about this. Mm-hmm. And I was like,
on a limb or on a whim?
Both.
On a limb, whim.
I was standing on one leg while I was on a whim. So I was on a limb. On a whim. I do it myself.
Hey!
And so like, we're just talking about the state of the podcast, and you know, it's obviously a hobby, right?
Yeah.
We not making money. We got a sponsor, which we're grateful for.
We're far from it.
You got 7 days to use code After Death with for getbeerfridge.com.
Yes.
Getbeerfridge.com. Use the code AFTERDEATH After Death. No space.
Yes, no space.
And get $10 off the next 3 months of your subscription.
Just like the beers that we had in the beginning of the podcast.
This one was at Aslan.
Aslan Brewing.
Organic beer.
Which they, well, I say recently, but maybe about 2 weeks ago, two, 3 weeks, maybe more. Two, 3 weeks ago, they had a collaboration with them. We weren't able to get the beers, but check that shit out. Also, you went to brewing?
He's into it.
I'm into it. I've already said this. I'm into it. I'm into it fully. Mango Golden Spike. And let me tell you, it spikes. Do you like beer? I like beer. Brett Kavanaugh likes beer. Supreme Court Justice.
We drank beer.
Yes! Yes! We like beer, bitches! We like fucking beer! I mean, we don't like fucking beer. We like to drink beer while, and then we fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought you'd like that one.
I fucking love it.
So I'm learning stuff without Chris telling me directly. Like, yeah. I'm like, hey, how do you do this? And yeah. If I were to do this, if I wanted to do this, yeah. How do you do it?
Yeah.
And then he's just like, I'll just do this, this, this. I'm like, okay, cool. And then I figure out how to do stuff like putting two sound bites together and exporting it.
It's fucking a thing of beauty, man. He's growing up, guys.
I'm growing too fast. That was an accident. But yeah. And what was I talking about? Oh yeah, I was on a limb, on a whim.
You were on a limb, on a whim. No, we were talking about beer fridge.
Oh yeah. At code After Death, it's AFTERDATH.
Yes.
Offer ends at the end of September. So once it hits October, that's it.
That's it, boys. Get your beer in. Like I said, if you type in After Death this month, you will get $10 off. October and November. So you can round out your fucking year.
Close out the year with $10 off some beers.
And let me tell you, you are not getting this kind of shit in your fucking local liquor stores.
Nope.
Unless you're in Washington. Shout out Raina.
In Birmingham.
Heather. In Birmingham. But you're not getting this shit anywhere else. It's literally fucking local breweries.
Yep.
I thought they were lying. No, I'm just kidding. No. No, but for real,
it's just
this
too
is
hard
like
to believe.
No, dude, it's like shit from all over the place. And I mean, it's like local. It's like locally. So it's like Whole Foods.
And not only is it good beer, but they support this podcast.
Yes.
So if you don't want to pay us for our OnlyFans and all that,
yeah,
get yourself some beer.
Yeah.
And support the boys.
Help the boys out.
Yeah.
Because we're broke.
Thank you for everybody who has used the code.
Yes.
Appreciate you guys. But yeah, so I was on a limb, on a whim.
On a whim.
And I was talking to Raina and saying, wouldn't it be cool if this podcast, like somebody watches it and somebody who has already a podcast and wants and likes what we do, you know, and wants us to produce for them. Like, hey, I need editors. I need like better lighting. I want your look.
Yeah.
Would you drop this podcast to work for them and get paid and possibly quit your full-time job? Like, say they pay good. You know what I mean? Like, say it's, and even better, say it's We Might Be Drunk. Mark Norman and Sam Morril, New York.
Wait, Mark Norman and Sam Morril want to do a film style pod?
Yeah.
They
don't have the best set.
No, they don't.
And
it's. But if they wanted to do that, like, dude, imagine if they wanted to do like the set of Goodfellas.
Yeah, wow. Like the set of Goodfellas. Yeah.
And it's like fucking cinematic as fuck.
Haven't seen Goodfellas, but yeah, keep going.
No.
No.
Not for that. You're just constantly coming.
We'll talk about that next, but
yes.
So what'd you do it? They're like, come out to New York. It's fun.
Come on, it's great comedy.
Yeah. Mark Norman said that there's more fake tits than black people in Orange County.
And it's true. That's why it was so funny. Fuck, dude. No, dude. I'd probably end up being on the podcast because I laugh so much. And they'd be like, Chris, shut the fuck up.
But what if they want like a role like that? Like you're the producer, like George is for Bad Friends, oh. Where it's like you're not in the show, but you kind of are. Everyone knows who the producer is.
Yeah. Or like, I think I would really like it, but
you could still do this podcast, but you got to take everything over there.
Oh, to New York?
You got to prioritize
them.
Them, obviously.
Damn. Actually, because I know the way it works, yes, I would do it. You know why?
Why?
Because they're going to be like, hey, you know our fucking producer? Hey, you know our producer has a podcast? Check him out. He's gay.
Yeah, he's gay. Yeah. Yeah.
It's one fucking shout out because we saw the power of that with fucking Jet Ski Juicy Johnson.
Yeah.
We saw the fucking power of that shit. So I think I would. I think I would. I wouldn't mind moving to New York because that's a fucking experience.
You know, my dream job would probably be, I think, stand up.
What? What?
Yeah. How badass would that be? To go on tour with people like Tom Segura. I mean, granted, it's a lot of work. And mm-hmm. I'm working on it. I'm working on some...
you got material?
I'm working on some material.
You fucking don't.
Yeah, I'm working on it.
All right, go right now.
No. No, it's not ready. Gotta let it bake. You know? Testing it out. I'm testing it out with Reyna. Reyna wants to be a stand-up comedian.
The fuck she does?
Yeah. Dude, that's how we met. How me and Raina met, we were talking about stand-up comedy.
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 What does that say?
Comedy. No.
Fuck, dude. I always thought about that, you know, like trying my hand at it, but.
Are there any Jews in any listeners, Jews? Get them.
It doesn't work because no one says in me.
Yeah.
Wait.
Somebody's saying it.
Wait, we'll put it in.
Get them. But yeah, it would be fun. No. You want a tour on music? I want a tour doing stand-up. That would be so sick.
Let's do a Dave Chappelle, John Mayer.
Probably kinda. Never. Yeah, exactly. Ooh, that would be sick.
Dude, and I've heard...
You do it.
Like, you know, you would think off the bat, like, John Mayer playing songs and then Dave Chappelle playing music or, like, doing stand-up would be weird.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, everybody who's gone that's not even a John Mayer fan is like, dude, this is fucking awesome.
I mean, yeah, me. When I was watching Bob Saget's memorial...
Oh, yeah.
John Mayer came out. No. Fuck that guy.
Peace and love.
John Mayer came out and
damn. Yeah.
Won't stop this train. What's this song go? How's it go? Can you play it on guitar?
Wait, hold on.
Wait, can you play it on guitar?
Stop this train, I wanna get off and go home again. I can't take the seat, it's moving in. I know I can, but honestly, won't stop and stop this train.
Gonna get claimed again.
I know. Wait, I'm playing it. Don't wanna see my parents go. And don't think I know the bridge? Oh, wait, no, fuck. The times I played guitar in this episode.
Yeah, but yeah. John Mayer killed. Like, great artist. I didn't know he was good. Mm-hmm. This motherfucker never showed me him.
Once again.
Even though he's on this wall right here. For those of you that don't know, that's John Mayer.
That's John. You probably can't see his... Oh,
can't see his head.
With the magic of editing.
We're not editing this episode.
I think I am. a.m.
It's gonna be extra late.
Yeah.
I'm peace warning you with peace and love. Peace and love.
I'm very busy.
I'm busy. After October the 20th, there will be no more signatures. I will not sign nothing. Nothing. It will go to the trash.
I will. Yeah. No. What is it? All your objects. Nothing signed.
Yeah.
Anyways, peace and love. Peace and love.
So yeah, would you? Would you have? Would you leave the podcast and or not leave the podcast, but try to have it over in New York? You'd move to New York?
Yeah. Fuck it.
Damn. I don't know about New York.
But think about it. They're going to pay you good. Dude, you know how much an editor gets?
They're going to pay. Okay, so they're not going to pay you great because they live, I think, in apartments too.
Everybody lives in apartments.
Exactly. So you don't own any property. You got to think about that.
Yeah. But you're not in New York to own property. You're in New York to fucking make it big. Then you move out to New Jersey to get property.
Ooh, doing Joey Diaz's podcast?
I thought about doing Felipe Esparza's podcast. Like, how cool would that be to produce?
Yeah, he would be fun.
Mm-hmm. I think we also...
I watch Keeping Up with the Nerds every week.
That's what I was going to get to. You do consistently watch that. And there's some interesting things that you find off of that.
Thank you for bringing that up.
You're welcome.
So
what a good co-host does.
Yeah.
They give good segues to things.
I've got a clip that you haven't seen yet.
But, I haven't.
We're going to watch it right now.
And I'm fucking ready.
I'm fucking ready. But these guys are constantly causing, they want to start a war.
And they got a war.
Dude, we don't even need my guns.
Vietnam, and we're Charlie.
We got these lights that would just shine in their face.
Yeah, and they can't see because they're fucking glasses wearing little bitches.
Fucking pussies.
Oh, shit, you're wearing glasses.
Shut up. Take them off, man. We'll edit them out. I got contacts. But they all wear glasses. That's the worst. They all wear them.
At least I have 20/20. I can see the rest of his shit.
You see 10/10, but you have no glasses.
I just refuse to get them.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
But yeah, so here's a clip, Chris. And I want your...
I think we need to put it on the big screen.
Okay.
Hit the 4.
He's calling the board the big screen.
Yeah, we need the... 2. Oh, yeah, 2.
All right. Let me know what... just speak your mind, Chris. Let it all out. Okay? All right. Because these guys, every episode, I wasn't sure if they were talking about us for the first few for the last couple of episodes. Mm-hmm. They were always like, "Oh, these people they don't want this and they don't want that." And
oh,
they're being very
very vague,
super vague. They never said it was us. But vague this last episode, episode 115, they said after the podcast, and I don't agree with what they're saying because Turtle was on this episode.
Mm-hmm.
And also spoke similar, like he had similar
views
on certain things, but on his podcast he saw another person.
Oh,
just like the master of disguise, Turtle.
Thanks. She-Hulk. What do we think about this week's episode, guys?
What did he say he thought about She-Hulk when he was on this episode?
He thought it was good.
He wanted to hit women.
Yeah. He did want to hit women. Little did he know that women would hit him back.
You're right.
And rightfully so. He's a weak little turtle.
Yeah.
And honestly, they don't even need to hit him. They just need to flip him on his back and he'll die in the fucking hot sun.
Yep.
Crispy like bacon.
It's opinion or are we doing the exaggerated opinion?
What do you want to do? You want to do exaggerated opinion for after death so that way they can just kind of like, you know... Yeah. Yeah, okay. God, man. This dumb feminist show, dude. I swear.
You guys are pigs. What the fuck?
Dumb, dude.
You guys are pigs.
Nah, it's...
Did we say that it's a feminist show?
Wow.
I have and I've texted him after a few times. I've told him and I've said, there's nothing wrong with women being on a TV show.
There's nothing wrong with fucking Megan Thee Stallion twerking on a fucking comic book show. Right. Is there?
I've only said I don't watch stuff that doesn't have to do with the main storyline. That's just me. I don't want to waste my time with that stuff.
Completely valid opinion.
Yeah. has nothing to do with women because Prey came out pretty, like, just before She-Hulk.
Mm-hmm.
Female lead, right?
Oh, yeah.
It has to be top five movies of all time.
Yes.
That movie is better, insane.
Better than the rest of the Predator line. But it's Predator.
Oh, yeah.
Prey.
Yeah.
And then the rest of the shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I agree. Fucking tell me.
Aliens? That we're being... A female lead?
Yeah.
Amazing movie. Nothing tops that movie.
So don't fucking tell us that we're misogynistic fucking pigs.
Oh, but they do.
You motherfucker who hits women.
Yeah. Hold on. I'll play it
for
you.
Wait.
If you forgot.
Wait. Can the court hear the evidence?
Look, I'm not against hitting women. Okay? Wait.
I rest my case.
Yeah. Disclaimer.
I'm sorry.
How dare you?
How dare you? Yeah. You mean to tell me that you're not...
woke.
Yeah, it's too woke, dude. You mean you have Megan Thee Stallion in his last episode, and now all of a sudden you're talking about, you know, women empowerment and all this other crap now?
Well,
fucking asshole.
Yeah, fucking asshole. What's so empowering about fucking Megan Thee Stallion and She-Hulk fucking wafting their twat air in the courtroom? That shit is nasty.
We don't need that. We see it enough in society. How dare they, dude? How dare they? You enjoy this show? You enjoy this? Stop pandering.
Bro, even your own fucking co-host was like, nah, it's not good, bro.
What's
it's
up,
not
Chomo?
Fucking good. Fucking you like watching Chomo? Little green fucking anime characters fucking twerk for you, huh?
Stop supporting the woke
culture.
The woke culture. All right? No need for that crap.
Honestly, what's woke about it? What would be
soundbiting that, by the way.
I'm just saying, what's going to be more woke? No twerking? In a fucking courtroom full of badasses?
Mind you, they're complaining about wokeness and all... Or
yeah.
They're complaining about us saying that they're woke or whatever.
So, yeah.
At the same time, mm-hmm. You know who they bring up in every episode?
While
they talk about She-Hulk talk?
Mm. Please.
Daredevil. They're like, where's Daredevil? We're waiting for Daredevil. It's not Daredevil's show. He's going to have a 16 episode.
Oh, wait. Say that again. Whose show is it not?
Daredevil is going to have a separate show, but every episode they bring up.
Damn, well, I thought Turtle could read, but apparently it says She-Hulk, not Daredevil. And apparently he's colorblind.
Right there.
And what you will. Scene.
Don't worry, Brian will destroy
Stop.
Himself.
Stop. Okay, look, this is a bit.
It's not a bit.
It's not a bit.
They won't know that.
It's a lot.
Was the last one we did that you said that, oh, yeah, when you'll see Brian's, when you think of that word, you'll think of Brian.
Incel.
Yeah. Disclaimer.
Did they just call themselves incels?
I think they just did.
Did they call us incels?
We're not incels because we don't fucking bow to that bullshit.
No, this was actually a good episode, and I enjoyed this one more than every other one, simply because I felt like the jokes rolled a little better.
Yeah.
Like, it.
I love how they talk about, they're always talking about, like, this was a pretty good episode. It was better than the last.
Yeah.
Bro, have you... If there's a good show,
mm-hmm.
It's good. Don't ever say, oh my God, it's better than the last.
No, what happens is you walk out fucking speechless and you go, damn.
Yeah, but the fucking motherfuckers.
A good show should not have to get an attaboy.
Right.
You shouldn't have to be like,
they're
wow.
Like, oh, well, yeah, no, that's exactly what they did. They're like, oh, it was actually surprisingly good.
Yeah.
I think that's worse than saying, like, I don't want to watch this show. It's not canon.
What if we went into like the Mark Norman show and we're like, wow, better than I thought.
Yeah, 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 exactly.
No, you want to be like, he fucking killed it.
Yeah.
End of story.
I didn't think you were going to be good, but it was actually surprisingly good.
Wow, everybody said you were trash, and you were.
Yeah.
But good job.
Yeah, yeah. Nobody that's exactly what they say. And I think that's more misogynistic than...
than anything, bro. If you really wanted to take it for what it is, If you really wanted to take it for what it is, you would say, damn, what a groundbreaking new show. But it's not new show.
No.
It's fucking trash.
And what do we say?
Comedy does get smarter. Yeah. Which I like, yeah.
It's okay. It's more aware of itself. Mm-hmm. And I think that it's accepted that fact.
Yeah.
I think it's accepted that fact. I think it's a smart show.
It just wants to just live with it. It's like, we understand this world, you know, the Avengers have trademarked themselves, mm-hmm. right? Oh, well, how did Doctor Strange?
Meanwhile, what the fuck are they doing in the background?
They haven't trademarked their names.
Like, jerked them off.
They're literally. that's their real names. Those are their real names. Yeah. Like.
Well, what, I mean, that's what I think I talked about it with you guys. Like, yeah, I feel like Tony Stark would have trademarked all the Avengers names.
Dude, I'm telling you, I think that Tony Stark would have, like, trademarked everybody.
Yeah. Yeah. He would have sold Avengers toys. Yeah, after Avengers 1, he would have been like, no, we got to trademark Captain America.
So,
and sell toys.
Yeah. That is a legitimate thing because there's a scene in this episode of She-Hulk
You got what you wanted in this one, because the last episode you were talking about how you want the bad knockoffs.
Yes. So in this world, in the MCU, the Avengers are trademarked.
Yes.
Because they're selling knockoff, the Avengers.
You see the Avengers. You see a purple Hulk.
Hold the fuck up. They already addressed this during the blip when everybody was gone. They already addressed this shit when Hulk became a fucking celebrity. And they had the masks on. Not only that, Peter Parker in Iron Man 2, in the flashback, he had the fucking Iron Man mask on.
Which technically exists, right?
Kind of. But
no, not kind of. It does exist. Yeah.
With a shovel?
Yeah, and then there's like an inverted color Iron Man. And then there's like
pause. They're just pandering to your fucking incel cosplay bullshit.
Nobody has like a different style, I guess.
Oh no, it was instead of it was
pause.
Instead of
Keeping Up with the Nerds was ripped off from Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Go ahead and fucking fact check me on that shit, bitch.
Yeah. Disclaimer.
Also, blue, it was red.
It was red, blue, white.
Mm. That was great. And then they have it all. Like, when the guy picks up the hammer and the cap shield, I'm like, "That? Why is that me?" Like, he's just holding it going like this. And he's just like, oh. Like, why is that me at Disneyland?
It's cool. It's cool to see it. And I'm very happy that they're playing on.
See, if someone tells you, like, hey, is that show good? Like, mm-hmm. I know you watch that. Is that show good? It's good. What do you think?
I'm never watching it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, thanks.
I'm never watching it.
I'm not watching that shit.
Yeah. Dude, I even gave him the benefit of a doubt. And I watched the episode one of She-Hulk.
Oh, yeah. And Miss Marvel.
And Miss Marvel. Let me tell you, Miss Marvel. And I will say it because content. Okay, when you're watching a show, continuity matters. The theme and the and the mood matters. So when you have a breakaway from those themes and those moods, you start to lose your foot in storytelling. So what happens in fucking She-Hulk is that they're playing her. They attempt to play her as a moody, I can do it myself, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. But when she's fighting Hulk the first time, she's showing that she's better than him and she can handle it. You don't give her that arc to grow.
Right.
So you already put her in a position of power. So yeah. She doesn't have anywhere to go. Right, so you just fucked up the whole storyline. So why should I care about a character who already knows how to do everything better than the Hulk?
Yeah. And he's been doing like... He's been 15 years of research. Yeah, 15 episodes.
Yeah, he's like, I'm trying to fucking fix myself, right?
Yeah.
And she's like, I got that shit in the bag.
It'd be like Spider-Man and Superman in a movie. It's like, bro, why are you even a thing?
Yeah, it makes no sense.
Yeah, it's like we already have that guy. Why do we need you?
Yeah,
yeah,
exactly. No, not on that whole bit,
right?
That was good.
Other than that, in all honesty, like they stuck with the solid A plot in this episode, which was the whole She-Hulk trademarking thing.
Her
right?
accepting the name and realizing and like
it's bittersweet. It's a bittersweet acceptance.
So I do think it's interesting that because I know that. I know that they were talking about it where they were like, oh, yeah, Born Again is not going to be a sequel to Daredevil. Not.
And if they really wanted to be woke, they would have just called her by her name, not She-Hulk. Did you just assume her gender as a she?
That's not a good argument.
It's supposed to be a, like, they're starting over. They're starting over.
But it's not the same. I hope they have.
They're sharding over.
I think they're going to have the same cast, but I think they're going to have different backstory.
They're going to have to explain that because, okay, spoiler, they show off the helmet at the end of this episode.
They show off Daredevil's helmet.
Yeah. Which is interesting, right? Mm-hmm. Because it you don't really get that feel watching the Daredevil show that was on Netflix.
Yeah.
He's able to craft his own costume.
Yeah. No, he doesn't craft his own costume. He has the guy.
Damn, Turtle just fucking whiffed it.
That's the, what's his name?
He's like the fixer or something.
Yeah,
like
he wears like big stilts.
Yeah.
Yes. Metal
stilts.
Okay.
But, that, but
yes.
Yeah, remember he saves him from Fisk's men when he's going to get killed and he makes him an armor.
Yes.
That guy was cool.
That's cool.
So this brings to mind, what is he doing in L.A.? Why is he getting his costume there? Right?
The bitch can't travel?
He got
fuck.
Bigger.
And so he moved to Los Angeles?
No.
There's been cases he's been moved around, like the Punisher in comic books and stuff like
that. Wait. I don't know why they're harping on this small fact of why is he in L.A. You got a fucking She-Hulk who's clapping with Megan Thee Stallion.
Of his,
I don't think anything's off the table at this point.
They still reference his former stuff. Yeah, Hell's Kitchen and his life out there. Maybe he needed to move
to
L.A. to kind of like...
They talk about...
Anyway, Turtle's bullshit and he's a fucking liar and a saboteur.
Saboteur.
He says where he.
There's a part where they talk about wanting to be on our podcast.
I literally
was waiting for that. Lies like no capes.
I think we'd have Renee on just to fucking break up the band.
Whereas this show feels like
I don't think
did
they
I say
would
that
break
out loud?
Up the band.
No,
when they're in the bar.
Yeah.
When
no, but if we get Nick on,
it really is.
Like I'm what yeah.
We
fantastic
could get Nick to
hair,
break
bigger body.
Break
yeah,
you know, like
so yeah. Fuck, keeping up with the nerds.
Yeah. We thought we were friends, man. We thought we were friends. We thought we had a bond. We thought we were cool, but, you brought out the claws, bro. You brought out the fucking claws.
That's it.
Fuck you, man. Fuck you, motherfucker.
I'll cut your fucking titties off, you motherfucker. Oh. You fucking cocksucker. I'll cut your fucking titties. Titties!
No.
The fuck I want your burrito for?
I'll see if we can. It's war.
It's fucking war. Today. No, that's it. Fuck, I was ready to give a speech.
Give the speech, bro.
Do it again.
Video is aimed at helping you understand some of the
what the fuck is this? Is this an ad? Today, we bathe in the blood of our ancestors and the men who are not mighty enough to stand in our way.
Hold on, I gotta replay this. No, you can't say that shit. Don't say that. No. Oh. After they're 18.
After they're consensually. And preferably with their company made of adult.
Okay, we're good. Oh, fuck.
And the next day. We will fight those who have any affiliation with keeping up with the nerds. And possibly keeping up with the Kardashians, I don't know.
What's
it
up,
will be trademark infringement. You said what?
What's up, Chomo?
Oh, yes. We know the Chomos.
Have a nice day there, Chomo.
Well, they shall be dead. Fuck, keep it going. For they shall be adorned with the sacred ritual of the Blood Eater.
That's how they return.
Goodbye.
Fuck, we went hard.
That was hard. You went hard. Don't. Yeah. All right.
I did have one more question. I did have a question.
What's up?
When do you remember the first time you got a boner?
No, I don't.
You don't?
No.
I remember.
All right. So anyway, what would you, if a famous person could pick up your podcast, what would it be? Who would it be?
Who would it be? Like any
dream.
Like if anybody saw my podcast, like anybody saw it and was like, oh,
I want to hire you. Both of us. Mine would be H3 for sure.
H3. We almost remember they had that application for a sound mixer.
Yeah.
We almost could have done it, but then we wouldn't have this. Honestly, I would think John Mayer.
If he had a podcast?
I mean, he kind of did have a podcast before people having podcasts were cool. I mean, like, there's podcast game in town, but he was doing Current Mood, which was Instagram Lives. Mm. And the production value he had on that shit, bro, it was crazy. He had, like, sets, bro.
Okay.
Off of Instagram Live. He would do, like, fucking SNL, like, concerts and shit with that. I think that'd be cool because he's doing a different format. And it's not like the traditional podcast setting. So I think that'd be really cool.
Anything else you want to... Oh, real quick. So you remember Alan Garcia from middle school?
Yeah, middle school.
Mm-hmm. So Alan Garcia. So I had posted
spiky
that...
Spiky haired kid.
Yeah, spiky hair. I had posted that I was selling my AirPod Pro Max, those headphones.
Mm-hmm.
His brother asked him, he's like, hey, do you think these are legit? And then he goes, I know who that is.
What the fuck?
Yeah, he goes, he's like, I know Ernie. He's like, does it say he's in Pico? And he's like, yeah. And I was like, what the fuck? And so he went on his offer up and messaged me and said, hey, bro, my brother wants to buy those headphones. He's like, can we pick them up today? And I was like, fuck yeah. I was like, dude, what's up, man?
Holy shit.
And so I was like, follow me on Instagram.
Uh-huh.
He's like, and then when I met up with him before I came here to the podcast,
yeah,
he was like, he's like, dude, how you been? I'm like, I'm good. I'm actually sorry it took me so long. I was waiting for, I was packing up because we're going to record an episode for our podcast. I'm like, you remember Chris? And he goes, yeah, I remember Chris. I saw that you guys doing that podcast.
Oh, shit.
So I was like, oh, shit, dude, that's what's up. Uh-huh. And yeah, he was just like, I hope everything's good with you, man. I'm like, yeah, you too, dude.
Fuck.
Shout out Alan.
Alan Garcia, yeah, dude. Okay, it's always incredible to me to hear that people are like aware of the podcast,
right?
Like, even though yes, we got like thousands of views, but it still feels so confined into like this room. Like, all right,
yeah,
we do it, and then we fucking edit it, and then we send it off into the YouTubes, and we're like, all right, yeah, let's take another one.
Honestly, we really just record it, I think, just to test ourselves. And that, yeah, in my head, that's what we do.
Yeah.
Like, we're like, what? How far can we push it? How nice can we make it look?
Yeah, how good? Yeah, dude.
Like, it's literally just for us.
Yeah.
It's a hobby.
Yeah, it's like the same thing with fucking music. Like, I'll just create a cover and just fucking try it and see what I can come up with.
Yeah. So it's just for the love of the game.
We love the game, unlike some other people. A light one today?
A light one, yeah.
I cannot underestimate, or I cannot undersell how fucking good this Three Weavers beer is. When it comes out, holy fuck, bro. That's going to be my new beer.
I think we might stop drinking different beers and just drink that one. That's a...
Cue the fucking Viking shit.
It's about to get fucking Viking in here.
There we go.
Three Weavers, listen to me. Release that shit now. I have an insatiable thirst for the beer that has no label. I need it. Well, technically, it does have a label. I'm not 100% sure that's what you keep calling it. It needs to be like sweet nectar from the gods. It needs to be descriptive and sexy and fucking delicious. Oh my god, goddamn.
Yeah, so I don't know if you guys heard that, but
it's really good.
Please drop that shit. That shit's so good.
It's so good.
Best beer I've ever had, hands down. And we told that to you.
And
Steven.
That's no lie. I don't know why I did that. It's no lie. Dude, it really fucking tastes good. It beats out Sculpin. It beats out fucking Space Dust. It beats out everything.
Stone.
And I didn't think I didn't like Three Weavers before. I thought I was like, eh, it's all right.
Yeah.
But
no, this shit's really good.
This new shit is a banger.
And I can't wait till it comes to our work. Anyway, quick recap. Listen to Wilder.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
Fucking go subscribe. Follow Cameron Zavala.
Follow Cameron Zavala. And we'll figure out what we're going to do with that audio episode.
His comic books are depressing and enlightening and fucking
emotional. They're just emotional.
It's like a sad song that you like to sing.
Yeah. And he
fucking gets it.
So follow Cameron Zavala. Mm-hmm. Cameron, CAMERON _ ZAVALA.
Yeah.
Cameron Zavala. Great artwork. Even if you're not going to buy anything, follow him, check mm-hmm. him out. Because his paintings, his line work,
mm-hmm.
fucking insane. They're like Dali.
Yeah.
And...
dude, it's just incredible.
It's surrealistic art. It's awesome.
And names that we can't even pronounce.
Yeah, exactly.
But
God, I wish that episode aired.
I know, dude. It fucking hurts me so bad.
But what else? What else? Oh, use code After Death on Get Beer Fridge.
Yes.
Again, you have 7 days from tomorrow. So, you have until September 30th.
Yes.
If you're listening to this before September 30th, just check it out. Try it out for a month.
You'll get $10 off. In the year of our Lord. 2022.
Close out the year.
Yeah. Close out the year with some fucking bangers.
Some beers.
And who knows, maybe Beer Fridge get on some Three Weaver shit.
Yeah.
With that new.
Check it
that
out.
That gush gush.
Send it out.
That gush gush.
Any other things that
don't
listen to
don't listen to Turtle and his fucking band of
incels.
Incels, yeah.
When you think incel, you think Brian. You want to combine and connect those.
Brian's dying.
You want to make sure that those are one and the same.
And their out cells. And all the sideways cells and shit like that. Mitochondria.
And if we can do it one last time. This is a serious message to everybody watching my update right now. Peace and love, peace and love. I want to tell you, please subscribe to the After Death podcast. Tomorrow's podcast will be late. I am warning you with peace and love. I have too much to do. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Anyway, peace and love, peace and love.
Wash my eyes, switch my focus, pull me back into the real world. I've got nothing but glass, broken glass. I know I got my head in the dark, eyes open. Keep my light on my face, stuck in my head. I couldn't keep control. We'll be right back.
This is a serious message to everybody watching my update right now. Peace and love. Peace and love. I want to tell you, please subscribe to the After Death podcast. Tomorrow's podcast will be late. I'm warning you, with peace and love, I have too much to do. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Anyway, peace and love, peace and love.
That's what I want.